The per diem module identifies your per diem allowances. These are your daily lodging limits and meals and incidental expenses allowances. The per diem amounts are initially populated by the locations and dates chosen in the trip itinerary. If reservations for lodging were made in the reservations module, the lodging cost will be modified to match the amount in the reservation. Daily per diem amounts can be changed by modifying the itinerary, updating the lodging cost, or entering trip details such as duty conditions, provided meals, and leave. You can access the per diem module by selecting per diem from the navigation or progress bar. There are a few features set on the per diem module automatically. DTS automatically groups similar days. This will display a single block for each date range with identical allowances. Turning off group similar days will display each day individually. DTS also automatically defaults to showing limited information about each day or date range. This can be modified by selecting the arrow next to each individual day or selecting Expand All. You may see colored bubbles or colored pills next to each individual day. These are indicators the allowances for that day are affected. In this example, the colored pill is first day, indicating the traveler will receive 75% of MNIE. Any modifications to the meals, duty conditions, or any selected other entitlements will appear here. These will only display when a day or date range has been expanded. Lodging cost is the nightly room rate for your reserved lodging. If you didn't make a lodging reservation in DTS, the lodging cost will default to the locality rate. The locality rate is the maximum lodging and MNIE that a traveler can receive for that location on that day. Lodging allowed is the lodging per diem rate the AO will approve. It may not match lodging cost in certain cases. For example, voluntarily staying in lodging with a nightly rate over the maximum allowable rate. MNIE allowed is the amount you will receive each day for meals and incidental expenses. The first and last day are always 75% of the locality rate because they are travel days. The reimbursement method is listed here. MNIE will always be personal. Lodging may be personal or GovCC individual, depending on what credit card was used to reserve lodging. To make changes to a particular day or date range, select the three dots to the right. On this pop-up, modifications can be made to the per diem. On this screen, items at the top and bottom are always visible, while those in the middle are on a scrollable portion of the screen, so they are not all visible at once. You have the option to select or type the date or date range these changes apply. In this section, you can check a box to identify situations affecting your meal rates, such as meals available or provided. Duty conditions affect your per diem rate. Use this section to identify conditions such as field duty, ship duty, hospital stays, reserve training, and more. Other entitlements also affect your per diem rate. Selecting options in this section can reduce per diem, provide no per diem for situations like leave, or increase per diem, such as when a document requires in place or the lodging cost exceeds the maximum allowable per diem lodging rate, and the choice of the hotel was not voluntary. Expense details allows you to change the method of reimbursement for your lodging only. The cost of lodging can be modified in this box. Once all modifications have been made, select Save Adjustments. In this example, we grouped the days together and edited the entire date range from July 16th to July 18th. Then we selected breakfast and lunch under government meals provided at TDY location. This created the colored bubbles and pills. It also reduced the M&IE rate from $55 to $37 per day, since the traveler is now entitled to the proportional meal rate instead of the full meal rate. To reset a particular day or date range, select the three dots and then select Reset. When resetting a date range, you will have the option to reset some or all of the days in that range. You can also reset all days by selecting Reset All Adjustments at the top. Be careful when modifying or resetting per diem amounts. In this example, the traveler booked a lodging reservation at $89.25 per night, but because they reset their entitlements, DTS is now displaying the maximum locality rate under lodging cost and allowed. If not resolved before filing the voucher, the traveler will be overpaid and will owe money back to the government. Other useful parts of this page include the GSA State Tax Exempt List link. If the state you are traveling to is exempt from taxes and requires you to file a form to claim the tax exemption, select the link to open the form. You can also adjust all dates at once by selecting Adjust Per Diem Amounts at the top. Once all modifications to per diem have been made, select Continue at the bottom.